guess who? It's me again.
Today's story is about a fellow by the name of Jonah. God had instructed Jonah to go to a certain city by the name of Nineveh to spread the gospel, to spread the word of God. And so Jonah didn't want to go to Nineveh. Now, the Ninevites had a reputation of being very vicious people. And there was a lot of sin that ran rampant throughout the entire city. And so Jonah decided, I don't want to go to Nineveh. You know, they got some bad people down there. Even though God had instructed him that they need to be saved also, Jonah decided, well, instead of going to Nineveh, I'll just catch the ship and I'll just go the other way. I'll go to Joppa. And so as he was going on the ship, there became a huge storm. The storm tossed the ship to and fro, and everybody became real scared. Everybody was wondering just what's going on. And so they woke up Jonah, and Jonah said, well, I know what the problem is. It's me. We're having this problem because I've been disobedient to the word of God. And guess what they did to Jonah? They threw him overboard. And as they threw him overboard, God had already prepared a big fish. And this fish swallowed up Jonah. And Jonah was in the belly of this fish for 3 whole days until the fish came to shore and gurgitated up. He threw Jonah up on the shore of Nineveh. Jonah being in the fish for 3 days, naturally, once he got out of that fish, he ran as fast as he could to get to the city of Nineveh. Once he got to the city, he began to preach and to teach about repentance and everything that God had given him. And lo and behold, the whole city repented. Everybody became saved. Now you think that this would make Jonah pretty proud, but it was just the opposite, because he really didn't care for the Ninevites. And so Jonah went up on a hill and he looked down on the city, and God had prepared a vine for to provide shade for him as he looked down. Now you would think again that Jonah would have been overjoyed that all this was happening. But Jonah was just the opposite again, that because the Ninevites had the reputation that they had, because the Ninevites were such a destructive people, Jonah didn't think that there was no hope for him, but God could save anybody. God saved the entire city. As a matter of fact, all the rulers got together and said everybody was going to be in sackcloth and cover themselves in ashes so they could repent. God bless that city. And as Jonah sat up on the hill, he became discouraged. And the vine that God had prepared for him, he sent a worm to eat the vine. And so as he became so frustrated, the Lord spoke to Jonah. And he told Jonah that, why are you so upset? All these people are saved. And this is why we need to share our story. There are some people that may not look like us. There are some people that we may not even like a whole lot, but we have to share the word of God. When the opportunity comes for us to share the word of God, that's what God expects us to do. And you being C agents, that's part of your responsibility. Anytime you get a chance to share the word of God, that's what we're going to do. So let's make a promise that anytime the opportunity presents itself, we're going to tell somebody about Jesus Christ. God bless you.
Come along with me. take a second, cause we all need Jesus. You ain't alone, man, we all got a reason to call on him in all different seasons. It's hard to find someone you can really trust, harder to find someone with unconditional love. It's a two-in-one with our Father from up above, so we don't gotta worry, he will always be enough.
All we gotta do is follow you. All we gotta do is follow.